troops have engaged the Farvati Reconstruction Park, Silver Bridge, and the submerged area. We need you to help our boys in those three locations. This'll end the war. It's time. That's the operation. Our friends are waiting.
Sleeping, that's your company commander. I felt some of you young fucks come down to my championship belt. Put the pressure on me. So I think I'm gonna go up there and run up the score a little bit. Just to show you guys how it's done. I trust I can count on all of you to keep up. Let's get out there, take care of business, come back in one piece.
Strider 1, turn line is to the north. Head that way if you need to refuel. Good luck, everyone. Our ground forces are now moving to capture Farvati Reconstruction Park. They're already engaged with the enemy. It seems the enemy was fast to detect them. They could use some air support.
Mitchell. Count is back in the saddle with Cyclops 2. Mitchell. It's gonna be flying with you again, partner.
Shit. No, it's real funny.
Evading enemy missiles!
Locked.
Hold up.
Target's still active.
Confirmed destroyed.
underway. All going according to plan. The end of the war is in sight. Think of something you'd like to eat, guys, because I'm buying.
Roger that.
Man, don't jinx us.
You're right. No bogeys. No, five SU-30s inbound.
It's Mr. X.
Two, hostile on your rear!
Cyclops 1 is down.
Cyclops Wiseman. He checked already, Wiseman.
I'm sorry, God. This plane exploded.
Wiseman, stay strong. We're not done here.
Cyclops 2, you've got the lead.
Wiseman!
Shit!
Negative, Cyclops 2, over the lead. I can't do it. Trigger should take command. The duty is yours. That's impossible.
Do it.
Damn it. Cyclops 4, form an element. We need our top gun if we're gonna take out that bastard.
Look who found.
Now I see why he's the king of the skies. Trigger's our only hope.
Missile.
Enemy on your back.
Missile.
Target locked.
Roger. Enemy has a lock on you.
Missile.
Strata 1, target acquired.
Forces are routed.
Missile.
Strata 1, warning, missile! I'm hit!
Missile.
I'm Cyclops One. Check your six.
You're quite the entertainer, but the show's over with this next shot. Those are the bad pilots.
Shit! Cyclops One is down!
Cyclops Wiseman!
He checked already, Wiseman!
I'm sorry, Count. This plane exploded.
Wiseman! Stay strong! We're not done here!
Cyclops Two, you've got the lead.
Wiseman!
Shit! Negative, Cyclops Two, you're the lead!
I can't do it! Trigger should take command!
The duty is yours.
That's impossible!
Do it!
Damn it! Cyclops 4, form an element.
We need our top gun if we're gonna take out that bastard.
Look, Count. These guys are way out of my league. I can't even get in close to them.
Connection with Mission Command. It's not just Mission Command. I'm not getting any response from outside our LOS. Brabante's now under Ocean control. The operation was a success. We didn't get the orders that should have come after the operational success. We'll guide you to the scheduled airport. All aircraft, leave this airspace immediately.
Negative. They've got a debt to pay.
Count, we all feel the same way.
Shit!
So Wiseman died for nothing.
This is a peacekeeping force forward base near Eruzian territory. Other Allied aircraft have probably been forced to make emergency landings at other airfields. We don't know much. The mission to capture the capital is nearly complete, but we unfortunately have no intel. The enemy communication satellites are down, and we have confirmed the deaths of several Eruzian leaders. But our enemy was smart. They had a similar plan. Our own communication systems were destroyed at approximately the same time. We have no idea when or if they'll come back online. Stand by for further details.
As far as the chaos we find ourselves in these days, it's difficult to say which side pulled the trigger first. Eruzia deployed an automatic intercept system with drones. Ocea implemented long-range attacks to bypass them. So Eruzia decided to sabotage Ocea's communications and navigation technology. Arugia couldn't launch a satellite themselves, but they were still able to hack the software of the Ocean transmission and navigation systems. Before Ocea even noticed, half of their satellites were hijacked. That's when things got ugly. In an attempt to knock out each other's capabilities, both forces launched fighters loaded with anti-satellite missiles at the same time. Only military satellites were targeted. However, their destruction created a debris field in orbit, which wiped out scores of other satellites, both private and government-owned. What kept the world relatively sane up to that point had been free-flowing data and information. But now, those were gone. All that remained was chaos and confusion. Government and civilian broadcasts and transmissions were cut off. The flow of information had ceased. Forces on both sides of the conflict now found themselves unable to communicate with their superiors. Many of the smaller countries annexed by Arugia and yearning for their independence seized the opportunity and started their own uprisings. As for why some of Ocea's military decided to break off from the main force and continue on their own, I have no idea. Perhaps there was some sort of dispute over the chain of command. The continent that had once seen wars that were only fought between Ocea and Arugia was now full of numerous conflicts between rival leaders vying for power. Insurgencies were everywhere. I even heard a rumor that a group of Ocean convicts had rebelled. Rumors. It never ceased to amaze me that even at a crazy time like this, something as trivial as a rumor could find its way here. Communications from corporate were cut off. Apparently, the entire computer network was down. It was a wise decision to make our drones autonomous with AI instead of being radio controlled. Wise and forward thinking. Even with their GPS offline, they can still use their sensors to navigate as long as they're working properly. I'm sure the drones are still working perfectly, following their mission orders to the letter. I wish I could upload Mihai's new data to them. But without a connection, I can't upload the software to the active drones. The new ones we're making, though, there should still be enough time to upgrade those before they're activated. I'll be taking the data I've acquired away from the front lines now. Oh, and I'll be taking the girls too. I told my assistant Masa it was time to get Mihai's granddaughters ready to leave here. She's not much older than the girls, but she has a way about her, and I'm sure she won't have any trouble with them. I saw a plane flying off in the distance. I imagine it was looking for a safer place. The plane had a rose emblem on it.
Arugia's communication networks have been down since their satellites were destroyed. Unfortunately, we are experiencing trouble too. All of Arugia has been affected, and we don't know when things will be back up and running. We're not even sure if this is Arugia's doing. Still, we will follow the strategy that was originally planned and move on to the next operation after liberating Farbanti. Let's get to it. Since the war began, we've been receiving communications in secret from an officer in the Arugian army. With the capital under our control, Arugia's radical element is losing support quickly, affecting the balance of power. HQ is thinking of using the military officer as a way to gain leverage to settle peace negotiations. The officer is currently hiding in the outskirts of Anchorhead Bay, having joined up with support dispatch from the Ocean Army. The plan is that they'll take a standard vehicle to a rendezvous point at a harbor in the east part of the city, where a helicopter will be waiting. I would like the new Strider squadron to provide escort for the officer. Cyclops will remain at the base on standby to serve as defense. With the communication network currently down in the capital, I very much doubt Arugia will be able to mount a regimented counterattack. However, it is likely that Arusia's intelligence department and the remaining forces who are aware of the officer's movements will interfere. Keep a close eye on the officer and make sure he stays safe. Our victory in Farbanti has given us a golden opportunity to finally end this war. Be safe out there. Take note that our satellite-based IFF has become unreliable following the recent communications failure. As such, target ID will be done by processing the images from the infrared cameras on your aircraft. Objects will initially appear as unknown on your HUDs, but will be ID'd once you close in on them for a set period of time.